I really love reptiles, and because of that, I was told that Dr. Close would be the best person to contact. He wanted to start research on reptiles and amphibians. So once I did, I immediately got started on getting together with him for developing research at Selu Conservancy. And now I have developed not only a love for reptiles, but also amphibians, because those are what we're working with at Selu. So we built a drift fence, which is essentially a barrier that interrupts the migration of animals. So we took construction fencing, the black tarp with stakes, stuck it into the ground and actually buried it. You have to bury it in order to, if any animals can burrow, they will get underneath it if it's not buried. So then along each segment, we set up two different types of traps. It's a pitfall trap, which critters kind of just drop into, and it's a funnel trap. It's in a box. There's a little funnel that kind of just coaxes the animals into the box trap. We're taking measurements of their sizes. For one thing, that helps us determine whether they are a juvenile or a subadult or adult. With snakes, the best way to determine their size is by the length of their jaw, because when you're actually measuring the full body of a snake, they do all sorts of movements. They are never the same length at the same time, but their jaw is actually very indicative of how long they are. We're also marking several different species with visible implant elastomer, which is a injectable elastomer that hardens right underneath the skin. It's non-invasive, or the most non-invasive that you can be with marking methods. It hasn't been used with reptiles very much, I think only once before, so this is revolutionary. When you mark an animal, if you recapture it, there's an equation where you can take the number of recaptured animals and determine an estimate of the population size. So this is actually being set up as a long-term study. The fence that we're building this summer is going to last 3 to 5 years. And the idea behind it is that you get an idea year to year of what's happening with the populations. That's even more valuable than just one summer of research.